Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know the anomalous behavior of the lithium with that of the other elements that are belonging to the same group. But that have made us to understand that if the lithium is basically different from the other group, it would be similar to other element belonging to the other group also. So for that we are going to discuss about how we see lithium and the magnesium, which is belonging to the group 2, they both are having similar properties. So now let us understand the diagonal relationship between lithium and magnesium. So now let's talk about basically how basically lithium and basically the magnesium are basically, they have the same property diagonally. If you observe the group, and this is the group number 1, and this is the group number 2 that I am going to talk about. And suppose if we have a period 2 on which basically the lithium has been belonging, and in period 3 or the third period basically sodium is present, while here basically beryllium is belonging to period 2 as well as group 2, and magnesium is belonging to group 2 and period 3. So now they both have relation with each other diagonally, and that's the reason the name is diagonal relationship between lithium and magnesium. So this is what I was discussing about. So how does they have the similar properties? Even that is the main concern of this topic that we are going to talk about. So now let us discuss about the first point, that is the first point is lithium and magnesium, they are harder in nature. Yes, we know we have got to know in the anomalous behavior of the lithium. So since we know that lithium is basically the smallest element in the group 1, so therefore because of its atomic size, it is more harder. So this hardness property of the lithium, which is different from that of the other elements in the group 1, is now very much similar to that of the magnesium. So therefore the lithium and magnesium, they both are harder in nature. So this is the first point, and now let us talk about the other point, that is so this is the salt of that is LiCl, and this is MgCl2. So therefore this two salts are basically crystallized from their aqueous solution in the form of hydrides. So but when we compare it with that is NaCl, so suppose in that case, NaCl, whenever it has been obtained from its aqueous solution, it doesn't form an hydride, it forms basically NaCl itself. But the lithium, which is belonging to group 1, it forms the hydride like LiCl dot twice H2O. While the MgCl2, again, it forms a hydride like that is MgCl2 dot 8H2O. So therefore, these are the two similar properties of the lithium, which is belonging to group 1, and magnesium, which is belonging to group 2. So this kind of similar property of formation of hydrides make them to have a relationship with each other and having a similar property. That's the reason we are talking about the diagonal relationship between lithium and magnesium. And talking about the next point, that is the hydroxides of the lithium, that is LiOH as well as the MgOH twice. So this both are bases, but this both are weak bases. While talking about NaOH, KOH, they are strong bases, and this is how they have a relationship with each other, and they are different with that of their own group. That is, lithium is different from that of its own group elements. And now let us move on to the next one, that is now we are going to discuss about some kind of reactivities from which we could understand that lithium and magnesium are very much similar to each other in terms of chemical property. So talking about reactivity of lithium and magnesium, so this is something which we have did in our previous lecture also. That is, whenever a lithium has been reacted with that of oxygen, that is we are doing combustion reaction, then the following is the product that we could get. That is, when 4 times of lithium has been reacted with oxygen in combustion reaction, so this is what we are talking about, and the product that we could get is basically Li2. So this is somewhere it is forming an oxide which is known as lithium monoxide. So I could write it over here as this is monoxide. We're talking about, suppose what if the magnesium has been reacted with that of oxygen, so now let us talk about that also. So this is the product that we have got over here, and again even this is a monoxide. So these are the two similar properties of in terms of the reactivity with of oxygen. And now let us understand that what will happen if it is been reacted with that of, or the metal is been reacted with that of the nitrogen. So this is the reaction that I have mentioned over here, that is when 6 moles of lithium metal is reacted with that of the nitrogen, basically Li3N is being produced, and that is known as lithium nitrate. And when magnesium is being treated with nitrogen, it forms that is Mg3N2, which is again to be called as magnesium nitrate. So therefore even they react with the nitrogen very easily, and that is how it has been formed. So that's it. So this was related to the reactivity with oxygen and with that is nitrogen. And now let us talk about the other properties by which we could say that lithium and magnesium, they have the similar property. So let us talk about that also. So the next is decomposition of the carbonates of the lithium as well as of the magnesium. So suppose if you are talking about the reaction in that manner, that is a decomposition reaction. For example, suppose if we have lithium carbonate, that is Li2CO3, and suppose if that decomposes in the form of that is Li2O along with that of that is CO2. While suppose if you are talking about the magnesium carbonate, and that could be represented as that is MgCO3. And if that is undergoing decomposition reaction so as to form that is MgO along with that of CO2. So the both the product that we have got is basically a monoxide. So therefore again it is a kind of similar property that we could see. Again we could see that the carbon dioxide has been liberated. So that is a common thing that we could find out here. But what happens when basically the other carbonates of the other elements like that is Na2CO3, when Na2CO3 is been forming, is been decomposed, so therefore it will give you Na2 plus CO2. So that is what we could get. But the thing is, the thing which makes it different is basically the carbonates that are being formed because of the lithium carbonate or the magnesium carbonate, they are not present in a solid form. While talking about the other, like Na2CO3, they are present in solid form. Again, this is the different difference that is what we could get it from its own group. But while it is very much similar to that of the other group, that is group 2. Group 2 is magnesium. So this is the reaction that we have talked about. And now let us discuss about the last one. That is, what will happen if it undergoes a reaction with water? So whenever the lithium metal and magnesium metal, they react with water, they decompose the water and in such a way that I am going to represent the reaction. So suppose if lithium is what we have introduced in presence of that is water, that is H2. So in this case, basically, we have to balance the reaction. That is 2 moles of lithium will be reacted with 2 moles of that is H2. So as to obtain that is LiOH. But it will also liberate that is H2. So therefore we have to balance it. So therefore what we have to do is we have to just fulfill the stoichiometry, and this is what we have got over here. So this is the reaction that will happen. And what will happen if again, suppose if I am talking about that is magnesium, if magnesium is treated with that is water, that is H2. So in this kind of reaction, basically Mg, it will produce that is, we have to use 2 moles of H2 over here, so therefore it will give us that is MgOH twice along with that of that is H2, and we are substituting over here as heat. So this is the reaction that we have got over here, and this shows that how that is lithium is very much similar to that of the in terms of property, it is similar to that of magnesium. So that's it. So this was the diagonal relationship between the lithium and the magnesium, and that's it that I want to talk about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you will share this video with your friends, and yes, we won't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much.